Trash. Oh, this is looking great, yeah. Hey.
What'll it be, honey?
In the air, spoiled scent. On the floor, rodent pellets. You sell filthier, don't you?
You're the health inspector.
I'm putting that sass in my report as well.
You know, at least the last health inspector had the decency to make it clear when he was asking for a bribe.
Yeah.
Here's $50. I get to live the dream for another exciting month.
Great. I must seek other opportunities for my corruption. Farewell, and thank you. So I hope that I can...
What'll it be, honey?
She has forgotten. Okay. I see a pale girl in my mind. Have you seen the pale girl, too?
Is that a trick question?
Do the pale girls play here?
Pale girls? Huh, like the Fitzsimmons albino. Yeah, she hasn't been in here in ages.
Child of the surf and his beauty. Have you seen this couple before?
Let me think.
Yeah.
Oh yeah, about 4 dozen a week.
Just 4 dozen? No, this is not too bad then. You don't get a lot of customers, do you? Thin blood. Do you know these words, perhaps?
Thin blood. Sounds familiar. Is that one of those tropical diseases?
From where did you hear the words thin blood?
I know I've heard that before.
Yes, the pale pretty flower girl muttered them, perchance.
Oh, that girl. Nice
yeah.
Girl. First decent human being I've seen in here for years.
Great.
Not like all the junkies and crazies I normally see. Yeah, I remember her. Yeah, weird. She left a tip, but she didn't order a thing. Yeah, she looked so hungry, too. Just sat there all night with a full glass of water in front of her, talking about this and that. She seemed lonely, a little scared, so I let her stay in the booth until we closed. She left some stuff here. You seem to know her. Why don't you give it back to her if you run into her?
Okay. Sounds great. But the flower girl is so close and she cannot come, so I will deliver them. Great. Anything
else?
What'll
it be, honey?
My kind is unsurfaceable. Goodbye. So nothing else. So what did I get now? I did get a purse. Cool. There's a photograph inside. This is Lily in Santa Monica. Jeans, bright shirt and red hair. Stop rotating, dammit. Okay, and... Oh, computers for Grandma. To begin, put the foot pedal on the desk and push the power button on the metal box. This is the house for your friend computer Chip, the enchanted electronic pixie that can do 4.8 billion calculations per second. Wow, that's fast, Chip! Do you see an image on the magical computer window? Reading this will boost... Will diminish my computer knowledge, I suppose. Reading it? Great. So, there was also a bail bond. A receipt for bail bond. For a Rolf Toten. And I'm rich. What else have I got? Let me see. I have still a t-shirt. Set of undergarments. And I have fists. With a brawl combat requirement. Do I actually meet this? I think I do. Okay, great. So, this looks really not like a great place to eat, even though... Well, the ovens in my own apartment here are dirty. So, who are you?
Something I can help you with.
Yeah. The night is as a cold... The night is as cold as a woman wronged. Why are you looking up there?
I guess.
What?
Arsenic.
Arsenic? I just heard a voice behind my left ear. Whoa. A strange weight lays on your shoulders.
I don't see how that's any business of yours.
dark and heavy your burden.
Goodbye, then.
Okay, who was whispering at me? A Malkavian being obfuscated? A Nosferatu being obfuscated? Anybody doing great stealth? Him doing some sort of, how you call it, ventriloquism? Don't know what this was. Yeah, the diner. So I have bail bond. Bail bonds. I know bail bonds. There was this Krime-Puter thing. Can I have a map somewhere? Anywhere? A bus stop?
Bus stop. Lonely suicides.
You are here. I am at the diner. This is correct. There's bail bonds up north.
Time of judgment gets closer every second.
Oh look, there's a turbine. The worm is hiding in the turbines. Can I open this? No, I can't. Can I? I could open it. With just a little bit more lockpicking, I could open it and have a look inside. No, this would be interesting. I want to do that. I want to do this now, but I don't want to waste my points, so, this is going to be a little detour. I will SHUT IT! I will reload, I will reload this, so let's upgrade this, and this, and it's at 3 now. I won't do this, I won't do this. At 4, so a blood buff will get me in. Go away, hey! I told me go away, email. I have never done this before. Tongue. This is a stupid password. Tongue. I want to see you soon. I'm bored. From Jeanette to him. I am not familiar with XOXOXO, whatever. Bertie, the stick in the mud is mad. You better lie low for a while. Notes. Obfuscate. This is great, I haven't done this before. Asylum. Run by vampiric sisters. I like Jeanette better than Therese. Gallery more. There is a back entrance in the alley. Weak pipes between parking structure and alley could be broken off. So since he has definitely seen me doing this, this ought to be fun. So can I? I wonder if you could see him by using a Auspex or something like that. This is why you want to have some brawling skills, then this is much easier. So, using some rats then to get back into shape. Yeah, I was about to visit Kilpatrick and his bail bonds to check out this Rolf totem before I got so utterly distracted. Now it works, doesn't it? Was that so hard?
Hello, LA. You
Okay, we are going to listen to the radio now while I'm reading all of this.
If you're new to town or just new to this whole radio thing, you're listening to The Dead of Night. The only girl who will spend the night with you and leave first thing in the morning, guaranteed. Well, looks like the boards are lighting up. Aren't I the popular one? Let's see. Eeny, meeny, miny, moe. Who will be the lucky caller? You've got the first shot at Deb tonight. So, who do I have the pleasure of speaking to?
Hi, Deb. This is, Vigo.
Vigo? So, Vigo, why are you up so late?
I'm working a late shift here at the, yacht club.
Uh-huh. How many boats do you own, Vigo?
Two. Actually, three. One is, in the shop.
I used to do a little yachting myself. What brand of yacht do you have?
You probably wouldn't know the brand. I, bought them in Italy.
Ah, la Italia bella. Parlate italiano?
Yes.
Arrivederci, Vigo. Caller two, you're on.
Yes.
The dead of night. Be gentle.
I am.
Hello, caller.
I am.
Is tonight
buddy.
A rerun?
Yep.
Caller number three, what's keeping you up tonight?
Deb, listen to me, Deb. They're at it again and people have got to know. They've got to know because they don't know. They won't report this stuff on the news because they own the news.
Hello, Gomez. What's the latest conspiracy?
Conspiracy? This goes beyond conspiracy, okay? There's no word for something as devious and secret as this, you understand? The people mm-hmm. need to hear this. They need to know the real story.
You've got our undivided attention.
All right. As we all know, the Americans established a moon base back in the late 70s. That's no secret. What mm-hmm. most people don't know is that they have been conducting a dig. Not for resources, but for artifacts.
I see.
Well, it's no coincidence that the Chinese have started conducting space missions. You know why? I'll tell you why. The reason is because the Chinese are trying to stop the Americans from finding an ancient space probe sent by the Beta Centaurians. And why?
Okay.
Because the Beta Centaurians are giving space technology to the Chinese to get back at the Andromedans, a.k.a. the Greys, for giving space technology to the Americans in the 50s.
Fascinating.
The American government's been putting more money into space. Don't you see what's happening? I can't believe I'm the only one that's figured it out. Am I the only person alive that can see what's going on? It's because the Andromedans and the Betas are going to be fighting their war in this galaxy through us, Deb. And the American people, the people of Earth, you people, cannot let this happen. It's Mool versus Atlas all over again.
Thank you, Gomez. And that concludes the news portion of the show. Well, this girl's got to pay her bills, so it's time for a few commercials. But don't go anywhere. I'm just getting warmed up. Should I say, hot.
Friggin' Chicken recently challenged several random people to a taste test between Friggin' Chicken and the other leading chicken-flavored products. Let's listen for which one they prefer.
Ma'am, care to participate in a taste test? Here, try this leading brand of chicken.
Oh, oh my gosh! Is that week-old fish?
Now, try this.
She lives in my same house.
This is some good chicken! What is this?
Sir, take a test for me?
Sure! Seriously, drop these up your
here, try this one.
Hey! Motherfucking great chicken right there! What is this?
It's friggin' chicken.
This is cat, right? Are you feeding me cat?
Try this.
Holy that's good. What the is this
9 out of 10 people preferred friggin' chicken over the competition. Why?
Cause that's some good friggin' chicken. I mean, friggin' chicken.
Friggin' chicken. You'll swear it's the best you've ever had.
The coffee
you
shop
love the talking
inside,
baby movie,
the
and
casualties.
The talking pig, and even the talking car in that show. You know the one I'm talking about. But now prepare for the most hilarious, talkingest, normally mute object yet. He's Steve Cash, a New York banker and recent whittler down on his luck.
And 10 makes 100. Here's your money, ma'am.
Ma'am, I happen to have a glandular problem. That's it. I'm withdrawing all my millions from this bank.
Cash!
She's an ATM machine with the soul of his dead wife.
There's something familiar about this ATM machine.
I love you.
Wow, those marketing guys are geniuses.
Together, they're learning to make the most of their special situation.
So that girl from accounting used me today.
Really?
She wasn't like everybody else. When she pushed my buttons, she was very gentle.
Oh, honey, if you don't stop, I'm gonna have to make a deposit.
Transferring cash. Wednesdays at 8:30 in the BMC. Say goodbye to yellow teeth and spots in your dirty dishes.
It's incredible.
Look at that shine.
Your smile or these dinner plates?
Harnessing the secrets of ancient Egypt, now there's a dishwashing detergent so powerful, it doesn't just leave your dishes spotless, it actually whitens your teeth.